In this video, I'll discuss the settings you can set on your CDJs with Pioneer DJ Rekordbox. Part 3 of the Rekordbox tutorial, getting started.
Consider subscribing if you already haven't and hit the bell button so you don't miss anything.
Hey guys, welcome to a new video. How are you doing? I hope you are doing marvelously well. In this video, that is part 3 already of my Rekordbox tutorial for beginners, I'll discuss what settings you can set on your CDJs with Pioneer DJ Rekordbox. You can set certain settings from Rekordbox on your CDJs. When you put in your USB drive in your Rekordbox, then export your stuff to that USB drive and then put your USB drive in your CDJs, your CDJs can't read those settings. Regretfully, those settings are a little bit confusing because they are highly inconsistent, definitely not Pioneer finest, but I have broken them down into 3 kinds of settings in the hope that I can more easily explain them to you. The first settings are the My Settings settings. Those settings you have to explicitly save to USB back in order to save them. Then second of all, the you can't change them on the CDJ settings. And third of all, the automatically save to USB settings on your CDJs. I'll start with the My Settings settings. You can change them in Rekordbox by clicking on Rekordbox Preferences. Then go to the tab sheet CDJs and Device. Then over there you will see a tab sheet that says My Settings. When we go over there, then you'll see that there is a list of settings you can set for the CDJs. I will pick out the ones that I think that are particularly important. For example, the play mode. I'd like to have that on single. Then a track stops after one track is played. The eject load unlock. You can eject every time if you want to. You can lock that, your eject, to prevent if a song is playing that you can't eject. Needle lock. Auto cue, hot load, hot cue, auto load, that's over here. I'd like to have that on, otherwise I forget to load them and then you are jumping to the previous loaded hot cue and that can't be in the previous song and that is really annoying. The loading time is somewhat longer, but that's a trade-off I happily want to do. Hot cue color, yes, you can change the colors of the hot cues on the CDJ 2000 Nexus 2, not below. Slip flashing is something that I'd like to have on, because if I press the slip button, then stuff starts flashing. So that reminds me that the slip is on. On-air display, if a jog wheel is on air, that means that it's playing and that the fader of the mixer is open, then that one will turn red. I find that really useful. Jog brightness, jog indicator, disc close illumination, language, SD brightness. Then there are a bunch of settings that you can't find directly in the settings screen of the CDJ, but they are settings you can set in other ways. Auto cue, yes, I'd like to auto cue for a track, so I leave that on. Jog mode CDJs or the vinyl mode, I'd like to have that on vinyl. The tempo range plus minus 10, what is the default? Of course, you can change that in the player itself when you're playing. Master tempo, is it on or off? By the way, I'd like to have that on plus minus 6. Master tempo on or off. The quantize function on or off, I'd like to have that on. The sync standard on or off, I'd like to have that off. Phase meter type 1 or 2. Type 1, there is a type that have blocks that are jumping and the other one is with lines, and I find that lines variant somewhat more easier. Of course, you can change that on the CDJ. Then you can't set those settings directly if you're using the Pro DJ Link connection. Now let's close the window. And over here on the left, we have the devices, and that is my USB drive. When we go over there, you see that the last top sheet, you have category, sort, column, color, and my settings. When we go over there, you see that these are the settings we just set, and those are the settings that are saved to your USB drive. Now we can eject the USB drive and put it in my CDJ. When we have changed my settings on your CDJs and explicitly saved them to your USB drive, I can put them again in Rekordbox and a message will display. And that message says, do you want to update my settings on the device? And if I want to copy those settings that I just made in or on my CDJs, then I'll say yes. If I don't want to, I say no. In my case, I say yes. So now all the settings that I've done in the CDJs that are now in Rekordbox, and I can find them again in preferences, CDJs, and under my settings. For more videos about DJing, producing, and videos like this Rekordbox tutorial for beginners, subscribe to the channel and hit that bell button to get notifications when I upload a new video. My second type of settings that I want to discuss is you can't change on your CDJ settings. There are a couple of things that you can't change on the CDJs, but it's really useful to set them in Rekordbox. You would think that you can change those settings in the Rekordbox options. Yes, you can't do that. I say Rekordbox, preferences, and on the CDJs. There are a couple of settings you can set. The problem is if you have a USB drive with already settings on them and you change them in the options screen, then they won't be saved to your USB drive. If you want to change your settings to your USB drive, then you have to go to your USB drive and you find those settings also over here. The difference being that the My Settings you can't change, but the things like the categories, for example, you can change, and those settings are saved to your USB drive. When I look at category, you will see that category is also over here. That's a little bit confusing. In other words, if you want to change settings on a new USB drive, change them here. So every setting that you do here will be copied onto a newly inserted USB drive. But if you have an existing drive, go over here and change the settings over here. I will go over a couple of settings in this video, the things that I find particularly interesting. I'll switch to the tab sheet category. And I can select here which categories that I want to see on my CDJs. On the right side, there are the active categories, the categories that are actually on the CDJs, and on the left side are the categories that are available. I have album artist, bitrate, color, file name, hard cue bank, label, original artist, remixer, time, and year. And here are my active categories: track, key, that's the key of a song, playlist, history, search, matching, folder, rating, BPM, and genre. If I want to move those categories, remove those categories, for example, genre, then I can press left, and then it will be somewhere over here, genre, but I don't want to. I want to add this one to my available categories in the CDJs. So it's a genre. If I want to have year, then I can select year. If I want to have time, I can select time, but I don't want that. You can also change the order if you want. If genre is more important to you than the track itself, you can place it on the first place. But in this case, genre I don't use very often. BPM I use some more. Rating, no, rating is more important. I use the rating not for the rating of a song, but for the energy level. The next tab sheet is sort. You have categories, those are the menu items you see on your CDJs, but you can also sort on certain items on your CDJs. You can sort on album, artist, bitrate, color, comments, date added, DJ play count, genre, label, original artist, remix, and time. And again, on the right, the active options that are the options that are actually on your CDJs, and these are the all available options. I've selected the active sort options. Default, you can't change that, that's why it's gray. The alphabet, of course, logic, and the BPM, the rating, and the key that I find, again, the most useful sort options. Again, you can move them up or down if you want to. Then there is a column option, and that column option is just one thing you can set. Next to your track, there can be a second column. And which information do you want to display in that column? Is that DJ count? Well, not very useful, I say, or key. And I'd like to have, if Pioneer is watching this video, I'd like to have two columns, one with the key and one with the BPM. So that is up to you. You can also select BPM. That's it for the you can't change them items on your CDJs. Next up, the auto-saved items on your CDJs. That are items, those are only two items that are automatically saved without doing an explicit save to your USB drive. There are two options, and one you can find over here. That is the waveform display. Which color do you want to have? Do you want to have that in blue or in RGB? RGB, red, green, blue, and blue for the higher notes and red for the bass notes, bass frequencies. And again, for those auto-saved items, when you put in a new USB stick, then the options of the option screen will be saved to your USB drive. If you have an existing USB drive, those options will not be saved. For example, when I look over here, I just, if I make a change to RGB in this case, then I'll close this screen and you will see that the settings on my USB drive are set to blue instead of RGB. So blue is the setting that is saved on my USB stick. I said earlier, there is missing an option in the option screen. Well, but that is present over here. I can set it to pink, that is the background color, or red if I want to, and then it is saved to my USB drive. If you have a question about Pioneer DJ Recordbox, don't hesitate to leave it in the comments below. For more videos about DJing, producing, and videos like this Recordbox tutorial, subscribe to the channel and hit that bell button so you get notifications. Thank you for watching, and I hope to see you in the next one. Bye.